Over the years, I have spent countless hours explaining to people how they can get their CCNA. So what I'd like to tell you now is five reasons that you won't. Reason number one, you're not building a real network. Some of you might have seen the debate that I had with Network Chuck, this is probably a few months ago, on the difference between building a physical lab environment and a virtual lab environment. When it comes to the CCNA, I'm telling you, there's no replacing a physical lab environment. I'm not talking the more advanced certifications. I'm talking the CCNA because that's when you're getting your wings underneath you and you can really build real things often for the first time. The difference between using a simulator like Viral or GNS3 and actually having a real lab in your house where you're routing your internet connection to a multi-VLAN setup where you're hosting a network attached storage, a NAS that has some files stored on there across this network, oh, there's no replacing it. And the number one reason that I see people die when they go after their CCNA is they get 100 pages in and they're just like, blah. It's just like school, learning things, right? No. The CCNA is there to build real things. Build, that's how you say it. Build real things to make sure that you know what you're doing when you get into the real world. Build a real network. Number two, you're not getting a deep understanding. And what I mean by that is troubleshooting. And this is actually very closely related to reason number one. I just thought of something really embarrassing. When I first went to go take the CCIE exam, you know what I did? I bought one of those yellow legal pads, you know, the ones nobody has anymore, where you flip the pages, lines on them, right? And I literally made a list of all the commands that I knew would be on the CCIE. List of commands. I mean, think of that. Syntax. I filled a yellow pad just, you know, enable, config T, you know, just writing all the commands because I was like, there's so much to remember. And when I got to my first attempt on the CCIE, I got blown away because it's not about knowing a list of commands. It's about knowing how to use those commands. And then I returned to reason number one. It's not real. You have to build something real, set up real things to really see things work and then fail and then try and figure out what to do to fix it. Reason number three, you think you have to know everything. This is one of the biggest discouraging feelings that leads to burnout is you step in and you're like, I have to know everything Cisco. You start Googling, 3 hours goes by and you're like, I feel like I haven't done anything. No, the CCNA, the whole purpose of the certification is to scope in the knowledge, right? They have an exact list of exam requirements. And yes, some of the things are vague, but as you dive into some of those vague topics, you're like, oh, okay, really, this is the scope. That's, by the way, that's what the certification does. It takes this ocean of information on networking and boils it down to say, you just have to know this to pass the exam. So use that exam outline, set it up, print it out, and start noting, you know, put little checkboxes next to the things as you feel good about them, as you feel like you can deploy or troubleshoot or whatever that task is that's on the exam outline. You don't have to know everything. Reason number four, you aren't Googling and you aren't exploring. This sounds a little counterintuitive to reason number three, where I said there's this ocean of information, you get lost in Google. No. Where Google comes in, and by the way, the lifeblood of an IT administrator is Google, right? You're spending 90% of your time on there trying to figure out solutions and troubleshooting, things like that. Googling comes in when you see the exam topic, you're looking at it, you're like, okay, I'm looking at the book and I don't get it, right? I've read it 5 times, I've underlined it, I'm like, I don't get it, you know, and that's fine. Not every author, not every book, not every video guy talking can explain something in a way that you're just gonna be like, snap, I got it, right? So that's where you're like, okay, spanning tree protocol, I didn't get it. Root bridge, what? Let me Google a little bit, you know, hop over here, watch that video. Oh, okay, this is a little, right? Google your way to success. Don't just get there and be like, I didn't get that, and keep flipping past it. And the last reason number five, you won't get your CCNA is because you haven't scheduled the exam. That's one of the things when I used to teach in a classroom environment, I used to teach 40 hour weeks just on the CCNA. And day one, I would say, right now, I want you, and as I got people logged into the computer, log in, let me get you on Pearson and get your exam scheduled. I'd get maybe 20% of the people that would actually do it. But my whole point was you got to set a date or else it's just going to be like, you start making excuses. Well, I don't know enough. I don't feel comfortable. There's just something magical that happens when you say, okay, 1 month, 6 months, what, 3 months, whatever it is, whatever you feel like you have a time budget for. And a lot of times, if you don't set a date, you won't make the time. It'll always be like, I'll get to that. And I'll get to that becomes, I'll never get my CCNA. Guys, I hope you know I took this approach on this video because I'm somewhat desperate. In a way, I've been saying the same thing for years. Like, you just have to do these things. So I thought maybe if I spin it the other way, I could tell people, look, if you don't do these things, you're not going to get your CCNA or your chances will be far reduced. So do it like when you remember when you were a kid and they're like, don't play that record backwards. It says an evil message. Like if you play this video backwards, it says a great message. Here are the five things that you really should do to pass your CCNA. It's that simple.